three meals a day, even though you work in a grocery store and sit and look at all that food. And, you know, it's just like, to me, I think that if we really want to get back on course with America, instead of saying, you know, I want to keep it the way it is, I don't want to keep it the way it is. I want my kids to be able to have an amazing America that's way better than I ever had. And I grew up in the 80s when things were still pretty decent, you know. But it seems like there's so many people stuck in this idea of, well, we got to just keep it at the status quo. And well, I think we can do better than that.
You're absolutely correct. And, I think I've got to correct what I said, because you said, right, I said, oh, Jessica did nothing wrong, which really was an implication. Well, okay, if somebody did something that wrong, should they really have to, their kids have to suffer these consequences? You're correct in correcting me on that. And let me tell you, I want to take it one step further. That is where I talk about how we've allowed it to be vogue, to be inhumane. In other
right.
words, we've made it. It is okay now. I wrote a piece. I did an interview, and I think I mentioned it earlier. It was the first iReport live interview that we did. And the thing about it is the following: I had to put in the little preamble to the interview that I wrote on the blog that you wonder, you know that something has happened when there's an alliance between evangelical Christians with a Republican Party whose policy is now based on an atheist named Ayn Rand. Think about that. That's a long statement, but think about that, people. The evangelical Christians who believed in the laws of Jesus, in what Jesus Christ stood for, I'm my brother's keeper, I care about the poor, etc., have adapted the policies, have come in support of the policies of the of a group that have stated they are for the Paul Ryan's budget, who stated it is based on the atheist named Ayn Rand. That says it all. That says it all. I have another caller. Thank you very much, Jessica. I'll keep you on speaker for the noise, and just stay on as long as you can, my dear. Who do I have the honor of speaking to?
Oh, hi. Thanks for taking my call. My name is Bill, and I just wanted to say something on this. I do agree with what you just said about the atheist. That's not really good. But I want to tell you something. I really got a problem with this Obamacare. I don't want my health care ran with the efficiency of the Department of Motor Vehicles, the kindness of the IRS, and the outdated method. Hold on a second. Hillary, I'll be right there. Sorry, my wife called me. Listen, I want everyone to realize the Declaration of Independence, and the host was right when he was talking about the atheist. It's not good. There was not one atheist that was the founder of our country. You know, the Declaration of Independence says God gives us these rights.
Mm-hmm.
But I want you guys to listen to me. You got to listen to me. I got a bad feeling about
that. You really sound like Bill. I must tell you that. But go ahead.
Well, that's my name's Bill Clinton. Listen. I got a problem with this Obama when he said the most beautiful sound he ever heard was the call to Muslim prayer. Come on, people, wake up.
Now,
this
look,
president, this
my
president's
dear friend,
a flake.
If we're going to have a real sensible discussion, we cannot start with those kinds
well,
of right-wing
are you
things.
Are you denying, sir, that Obama said that?
I am not denying or anything because I don't know, but I don't care. But, my friend, we're in a
you
substantive
don't, sir,
we're
you don't care that the President
really
of the United States, who supposedly...
Okay, Mr. Pomponio, come on back in, my friend.